Onivia, League of Legends highlights.
So it's going to be difficult early, a little bit more difficult early, as the Trundle is going to be locked in. All right, I like this.
So Trundle support here for Barrel in the bottom side of the map. It'll be a bit of a bait played out from Showmaker, but minions here and Umpty here. I don't know about this.
Umpty's going to spot him. There's the flash forward as Lava actually flashes on top of Showmaker. Immediately gets out though, and Umpty's going to get taken down. Barrel as well. Going to need to flash here on the bottom side as the piercing arrow will take down the Trundle. Ghost wasn't even there.
Fortunate. Henna also flashed, so I guess there's that. As that's a great stun.
Q's going to connect as well. And it's exactly what this combo can do. The flash out, the safeguard, and Canyon. He wants to get to 900 points, I think. As now Umpty's in trouble. Showmaker only level 5, so he's not going to be able to use the ultimate or anything like that. But he's going to be able to slow down Umpty here as Barrel moving on over. And Umpty's just going to get scattered to death.
Yeah, Umpty dies here. Lava gets out. But, you know,
at the end of Trundle skin was probably one of my favorites in the game. And unfortunately, it does not exist anymore. That pink Converse shoe was just the best. I just loved it so much.
We'll actually get to see that, and what actually eventuated is over goes Canyon. Looks to get underneath this turret as, it's just a very comfortable kick, and Canyon's going to be able to tank up that last hit. And more plates going to be. That is going to be yet another Drake going over to Damwon Kia. A couple away from getting that soul, and we do have an Infernal Soul this game as well. Going to continue that one kill. It's all that separates Damwon Kia from a perfect game this time around.
Okay, Delight.
It's only getting worse as Canyon lands the Q onto Delight, but of course, tricky target to lock down. Showmaker's going to do it though, as Delight takes half of his health bar. Shirley still here, because now Umpty's in trouble. Crescent Guard comes through yet again, the kickback onto the Xin Zhao, and yeah, you can ult. Is going to survive, is now Canyon gonna get, going to get knocked up. The flash forward from Barrel was odd, and he's going to get taken out, but it's going to be traded. A double kill somehow for the Rakan, as Delight's decided that he's carrying. Henna's decided that he's split pushing.
Yeah. Right, actually, I think I told a bit of a lie there. So, two turrets for one, but being able to win out on the trade, especially when you were that far behind, certainly a good feeling. As Chains of Corruption come out here, let's see whether Khan's Meganar is going to work out here. Takes a lot of damage, as already they've traded. Delight just falls and Khan crushes his way out.
Ghost also now trying to be able to get this kite working as he flashes away from Hoya. Good knock up there from Umpty, but a bit split on the focus here from Fred at Breon. As Damwon Kia now with the man advantage, also Khan with teleport. Will be able to get back for this fight around the Infernal Drake.
There's a lot of poke here for this Varus. You have to respect it in these longer fights.
Yeah. Canyon going to be able to get himself out here as Hoya now doesn't have. Okay, my goodness, Showmaker, so much damage. The four-man stun, theoretically, except one of them was dead before anything could happen, and the Realm Warp is going to be an evacuation tool as Damwon will be able to lock down this Drake. Barrel still looking for more, as you can see. Crescent Guard with still half of its cooldown left as Umpty. Gonna get spotted. They're fighting over the Brambleback. Showmaker immediately just pushes the Xin Zhao away. Not so audacious on that charge, unfortunately, as in goes Canyon now looking for his opportunity. Chains of Corruption connect, but the junglers are gonna get traded. Delight also limping away from the fight, and a one-for-one is good for Fred at Breon, because they're the team that's behind. As Khan, he's decided that it's not actually going to be a one-for-one as he locks down the Meganar. Flash is available, but he's holding on to kill him. It's likely that he will just die.
Khan is about to have his Gnarbar too. He did not have it at the start of this exchange, but he is going to have it now.
Yep, a lot of big buttons available. It's just the Enchanted Crystal Arrow that's on cooldown. Pillar now down as well, though, as Delight gets on in there. Have a look for the quickness as in goes Hoya, finds the flank, but my god, the scatter of the weak is huge. The Gnar is even bigger as Damwon Kia trying to get this one worked out, but no, the interruption on Canyon's approach. And now it might just be enough here for Fred at Breon as Showmaker. Yeah, they don't have a smite. As Umpty didn't even have to use his by the look.
Yeah, they are going to move on over. They need to check everything though. Hawkshot gives Damwon Kia all of the information.
Blue Trinket goes down. Showmaker lying in wait off to the side, getting all of the orbs in position. Piercing Arrow is going to go wide. As Barrel comes on through here, they get stunned, both of them, in fact, by Lava. Throws out the Everfrost as, oh no, Canyon gets the kick back onto Henna. Oh, he does go down, but that is exactly the target he was looking for, as now Umpty doesn't have that Crescent Guard available. Boulder connects onto Lava, who is now going to have to carry this one. Does do a fair bit of damage as Damwon Kia continue to press forward. Hoya diving on in. Barrel, though, is going to be absolutely fine. And Umpty, oh, Showmaker just says goodbye. That's it. That's called the you're no longer playing the video game button.
Oh, the double!
Yep. The scatter of the weeks are just so beautiful. There's the stopwatch that Showmaker had been holding onto this entire time. But the Cyclone's fantastic Realm Warp to try and get Lava out, and it is going to do it as Beryl spots him out. Delight is here, both of them on absolutely no health. And Delight sacrifices himself for his pirate captain, Ryze. And it may not have actually been enough as there's a pillar to lock him down. Triple kill for Khan in the end, but I think Fred Breon may have
damaged there by a bit. I mean, quite a lot from Showmaker.
It's just so hard to walk through into this pixel brush right now. When you don't know where Showmaker is standing, you could your whole team could be stunned.
Oh, look at the knob off of Khan as he wraps around. They have the information. So Fred Breon likely not going to walk into it. As all the scatter onto Hoya denies his engage with the Nimbus Strike. Now Khan with that huge knob. Oh, the steal from Henna is going to deny the Infernal Soul once again.
Time to evacuate, though. You got to get out of here.
They certainly do. Henna's going to get slowed down. As in goes Canyon, gets the kickback, but he goes the wrong direction. The Wallop is going to connect, though, and Khan says that he's going to save it, and he absolutely does. Lava, he goes into his Zhonya's, but unfortunately, it's in amongst five people, and Henna just can't do anything. One versus five. It was a bit odd with how it worked out. However, Damwon Kia are going to run over the fight. The arrow's going to connect again as Ghost proves that he is just the better Ashe on the day. And Damwon will be able to break open the base.
They have a minion wave here, so that is just going to be the push to end. Very easy cleanup for Damwon Kia when they turn the fight. It was looking a little bit scary there for a second. The steal did come through, but they end up getting caught. Damwon Kia playing our first Syndra on this new patch. It wasn't about the mana, I don't think. It was about Showmaker just absolutely crushing with his Scatter of the Weeks all game long. And there's another
Another three-man, just a casual three-man. Okay, let's see whether we can kill the Nexus before Khan dies. And they are able to do that. So a 2-0 for Damwon.